He looks like he has good rear angulation, a nice top line, a nice tail set. But to me, I don't think he has a lot of neck, right? Like, I think his balance would be helped by having more neck be longer. So do I think that dangle saddle trim is necessarily the right trim for him? I'm going to say that actually I don't, right? Because I think for English saddle, we need to have more neck to really carry off the balance of the trim. I think by putting him in English saddle, we're going to lose a little bit of that neck, a little bit of that elegance. But here we are, right? And then maybe we can do a seminar where we put him into Continental and show you how much better he looks when he's in Continental, right? So that's what I mean by typically examining the dog. Does this trim fit there? How can I make the best of this trim? So one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to try to keep the top of his pack. So the ankle saddle is also called the pack, and this is the pack, is this top part, right? Then these are called bracelets, pom-pom on the tail. So sometimes people call everything a pom-pom, and that's completely fine. Sometimes I do too, right? You have to talk a lot about poodles. But if I try to call these bracelets and this pom-pom just for reference. So the first thing that I like to do when I'm setting this trim, like I said, is I'm going to keep this pack as tight to this little butt as possible. So the first thing that I did is that I shaved his tail, right? So I shaved the base of his tail. Like I said, you can come up and see him later, but you can see, and you can see how the base of his tail is shaved in a little V going towards his head. And that's because we want to, it's called the tail set, so we want to make the tail look like it is actually set into his body. Now, the length of how high I shave the tail from the base of his tail to the bottom of the palm is the same length as the base of the tail to the tip of that V. That's how I create that balance, right? And again, the width of the V here is that same length, right? So it is basically an equal triangle when we're doing it. And then whether people are putting their dogs into Continental or English saddle, one of the mistakes that I see people make in the beginning is they start with this line. Okay? So this will become the jacket. Whether we're in Continental or English saddle, this becomes the pack and or Continental would have a rosette here. And the reason that I don't do that is once you have set this line, you're committed, right? If you think that you've made the pack look too long or too short, you have to grow this area out. So I choose to go from the back of the trim towards the jacket so I have it looking down. The other thing that I hear all the time at grooming shows, people coming up to me, etc., is that the back of the jacket goes at the last rib. Okay? So that is another fallacy. Right, that's another urban legend. Maybe, you know, many years ago, like that's where it went, but when we were trying to create balance in our trim, we're trying to make the dog look balanced front and rear. And if the jacket does end up at the last rib, that can happen. So I don't want you to think that you were wrong because it ended up at the last rib, because if the dog had a longer or shorter rib cage, that could happen. But it's not a designated place on every dog that you are going to put that jacket at the last trim. So that's what we're talking about. The other thing about all my trims, whether it's Continental or puppy English saddle, is when we're trimming in this front piece, there is a reason that the front is trimmed a certain way, right? So if we think of his withers are right here, right? And then his point of shoulder is right here. And we followed our finger down from the withers down to the point of shoulder along the top of the shoulder, the scapula. That should be a 45-degree angle, right? And then the return of upper arm, so from this point of shoulder to the elbow, should be another 45-degree angle, creating along this axis 90 degrees of shoulder angulation, right? We've all heard that, we've all read it, that our dog should have 90 degrees shoulder angulation. And that's what that really means. Well, you know, not all dogs are going to have that. So it's your job as the groomer to really create that angle in your poodle. And one of the ways that you can do that is when I clipper this line into his neck, I do it on that 45-degree angle. Whether it's puppy trim, you'll see this out and decide that that's who it should be. 45, 45, right, for a 90-degree angle. And then if we continue along that axis to coming, the same thing would happen in the rear, right? So from the hip bone here to the pin bone and then back to the knee, this would be another 45 degrees, and that's what we mean by balancing. So those are some of the things that you should think about when you start building these trims in. When it comes to the English saddle, I don't like any of my bands to, like this top band should not be in an angle, it should be straight, and it's going to be straight across from the elbow. So that sets the bottom of your pack and the top of the middle bracelet. And then I like the back bracelet to be level with the front of the front bracelet. So with all those things said, let's get to it. So first of all, he was bath and dry, he was combed out, and I used a really fine comb on him, and now we can start with the trims. So I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this, so I'm not blocking. And if you have to move, because I'm getting in your way, I'm trying to not get too much in your way. Let me just do the same. Brush or comb our dogs dry. We're always using some kind of scissoring or brushing spray. So like I said, if I went to jump into this trim and I just put the jacket at his last rib, his jacket would be about there, right? And I don't think that that's going to make him look balanced. What I want to do is I want to think about the 45 degree angle that I'm creating from the hip bone to the pin bone and back down to the side bone. I'm even going to put my glasses on so that I'm really going to make it look good. So I just like to take this, now again, remember he doesn't have a lot of neck, right? So if this was a really small poodle that had a big long neck, I might leave this tall, right? But because he is bigger and has no neck, I want to keep the top of this jacket the top of this pack as short as possible. So I'm just going to keep going back and forth along that. On the tail, I have combed all of already clippered in that V. So I'm going to comb the hair towards the inside of the V and then set my scissors on the V, slightly facing out, and cut in that V for his tail set. Right? And I'm just going to start looking at his trim, making sure that this gets as tight as possible. Then when we start to look at his trim, we think, okay, is that going to make him look balanced if we bring it in there? So now that I think that is, when we look down at the pack, we're going to follow that same angle that we clippered that triangle in, right? So remember that there is a reason. You don't really have to guess. You're just following the natural lines of your dog. Right? We decided how high up his tail set gets shaped. That designates how long the bee is. That designates how wide the bee is. Now we know that the angle that bee is on, my scissors here on the bee are just going to keep on that same angle but just move to the outside. Because when we look down at the pack, we want it to look slightly heart-shaped. Right? And you'll be able to see that way. We'll bring down and put them on the bee. And remember, like, we have to make sure that he's standing square all the time. So if my scissors on that angle, I'm just going to start. And I'm going to shy away from like going right up to the jacket in case I change my mind. And I'm going to bring this all the way down the outside of the leg. And that just starts to create. Now when I get to this tuck up, I want to make sure that I'm not digging into that tuck up so much. And I want to keep just pulling this hair up. So I don't want to just scissor to here and then make a big bump out. I want to keep this like a nice straight line. So I like to think of this as an A, right? So this is an A, a capital letter A, goes from here down to the foot. same thing, and then on this side, the same thing. Although, when I am trimming dogs, especially for show, I really want the weight of the legs, of the back legs, to be 1/3 of the hair on the inside and 2/3 on the outside, right? Judges are always thinking that our poodles are moving close behind. Judges aren't used to looking at poodles that have those weird shaped legs. So to do that in all of our trims, our puppy trim, our continental, our English saddle, brings consistency to what we are presenting to judges and then how they can look at trims and judge our dogs, right? So, and that's why, like, you know, guessing is fantastic. I have done it for a long time, but having like some kind of grid that you can follow can be really helpful, especially if you are kind of learning these trends. So I want to take that all the way down to the front. And then once I start looking at this, I see that I have that line there. That looks like that's going to be balanced. Remember, I haven't done this cut-up yet. So now, before I get to my clippers, I'm just going to take my straight chair and I'm just going to run down this line, creating this line for the pack. Once I've done that, I'm just going to take that hair out. Then I'm going to comb all of this coat on the jacket back over that line. I'm going to place my scissors on that line again, and everything that comes up, this starts giving us the roundness to our jacket. So again, you know, your scissors are going to start pushing that hair up, especially he is actually just over a year old, so his hair still is kind of soft. And I'm just going to keep going over this line, kind of tapering it up, and this is what starts to give us that nice round look. Okay, the other thing I don't want to do is here is his pin bone. I don't really want to build a big shelf out of the back, right? So a lot of people will build this big shelf coming out the back of their poodle, whether they're doing it for a puppy trim, and they think that that gives them like a better shelf, or it makes them look like they have more ambulation. To me, no matter what dog I'm trimming, an Irish Setter, a Springer Spaniel, a Doodle, a Boodle, the more that we can make our trims follow the natural lines of our dog, the hair, the furnishings, the leg hair, whatever you want to call it, should be a natural extension of the bone structure. That's what's going to make our trims look more balanced. And also, as soon as you start making something look unbalanced by bringing out this shelf, by creating this big shelf, that's when you get into trouble, right? Because then, how short do I make this? I make this bigger, so now my pool looks long like that, right? It just, and same thing, Springers, Irish Setters, you want those furnishings to look like an extension of the bone structure of your dog whenever possible, right? So whether it's in puppy trim or English saddle here, because it's actually quite similar when we're setting these lines. You could pull all this hair back, and then sometimes I'd like to, I call it cheat, I'll take my curves and I'll hold them backwards, and by, apparently the center's a lot. Maybe, you know, everybody works for a living. Including me. So by backwards, I just mean the point of the curve facing my face instead of facing my dog. And I just like to go like right here, like my finger is on his pin bone right here. And I just like to take this as close to his little booty as possible because I think that that's going to make him look shorter back. I'm going to make him look longer neck. That's and when I bend his, I'm sorry. You stop kind of taking that hair off equal to back equal to where the band is. Right? So he's had a bit too much hair taken off down here. So I want to make sure that I'm not doing that today. And that's how we start setting kind of this first line for our pack. So now the next thing that I would like to do is I want to make sure that I have this front piece trimmed here. Alright. So I don't want to go above the elbow, I don't want to go below the elbow, I want to go right at the elbow. So sometimes I'll take my straights and I'm just going to go right in at the elbow. And I like to pull all this hair like slightly down because then it just kind of helps me get my work done and put my scissors right on that line and start printing that. Remember we want this to look slightly tear-shaped when we're done. Right, and for me, the front bracelet always starts at half of the front leg from the ground to the elbow. I'm not very good with fractions, but we're going to say that maybe that's about half. And especially here in Southern California, no matter what trim you're putting your poodle in, especially continental, but angle saddle these front legs, you know, I don't do it on a 40 or a 50 or the shortest on my trimmer the first time. I like to do it with a 15 because, you know, we want them to have a suntan. We don't want them to get a sunburn, and it's really, really easy to do especially this time of year, right? And, you know, I've even used sunscreen on something that I've been worried about. I'm not going to worry, these will have to go around, but, you know, as a general rule of thumb. The first time you cut them out, so their skin toughens up a little bit, and their teeth is just slightly longer. So all we're going to do is kind of follow the lines that we made. And so from the elbow, and I like to just put my finger like where, like, because sometimes, you know, they jerk and the clipper goes too far down, and it's going to go right up to that elbow, kind of all the way around the leg, hopefully. So once we have feet, so once we have that done, now one thing about poodles, and when we talk a lot, and if you've been on any of my courses or you hear me talk about it, put their hair stuff in here, line a little bit. So I like this line, so this is our underline, and I want it to be a continuous line that goes under my poodle, okay? So what I mean by that is I see a lot of people and like the chest line comes down and maybe ends at the leg here and then comes out down here or vice versa, right? The underline should be a continuous line that goes under our dog. So again, setter, spaniel, doodle, poodle, whatever it is, I think that that's really important. I always like to cheat and use a curved shear right here because I just think it makes my life so much easier. And one of the things that we talk about when we are doing any of the adult trims, so the continental or the English saddle, is the height of these front bracelets, right? I think that we should always start at half. Some people think that they can make their dogs look longer legged by moving these front bracelets down. And to me, it just makes them look like it pulls your eye down. Remember, with the poodle, we're always trying to pull our eye up. We want them to look like rectangular this way, right? It says that, you know, with all their top knots, they need to look like they... And again, when I'm doing the front bracelets, from the front, if we're using the bone, if we're using the middle of his bone, I want them to be equal here, but the front of the front bracelet should come out at the arch of the toe, okay? So that's how you decide how big your dog's front bracelets are, is from the arch of the toe, bringing this right up, don't reach it down. Then so now I know how that front bracelet starts. And again, right, we're using our dog's body structure to teach us where to put the trim. So now that I have that, I want from the middle of this bone leg, I want this to be two-thirds and this to be, two-fifths and this to be three-fifths of the width of the bracelet, right? And you can't really see. I know, is it really terrible that you have to stand up for like a full 45 minutes? So the tips on the front, which is, and I don't have to guess, right? That's at where the arch of the toes is. So this is whether I'm putting it on the cubby trim, whether it's a continental, like that's where the front of the front leg is going to come from, the arch of the toe. So when I'm doing that, I know that that's 2/5 of the size of my waist. So this is 3/5 because we always want this space to be a square, right? If we're going to default, it's going to be a rectangle this way, right? We never want this negative square space to be a rectangle this way, like a number 8 level, right? Because the more negative space you have here, the longer back our poodle looks, right? And, you know, for many, many dogs, we're not trying to make them look long. We're trying to make them look at least square. And sometimes a poodle's a little bit shorter than square. So that's how I set that line. And then from this line, right, the top of the elbow, I'm going to go straight across, and that's where the bottom of this jacket is going to sit. So again, I want to make sure that it's nice and straight, so I have the elbows come out, so. I'm going to go straight across, don't move. So this is why it's important to always make sure that we can go square, and I'm going to go straight across from here, and this is where the bottom of this calf is going to be. Right? Top of the bracelet is where the top of this, yeah, I don't, see if this hair is like super soft because of the toughest, I kind of want to pull this up because I can make it look fancier at the end of the day. So I go straight across from here, and I put the top of the bracelet right there, okay? So that's how we start setting the lines for the pack, and then once we have those lines set, we can go in and start making. It's not really that difficult to stand. I have also been standing the entire time. All right, so now, let me see. Did we put this in? I'm gonna try to, oops.
Oh, you're good.
So I'm just going to take a clipper and write where I put that. I'll put my glasses on. Okay. It's not that bad. Okay. Making sure that he's four square. We don't want him standing like a pretzel in. So now I'm going to use my clipper. I'm just going to go straight in, right? I'm not going to like carve out anything. I'm not going to go up. I'm just going to go straight in and just kind of make like a little tiny. Right where I want that band to be. You don't want this to be very big. And then where the second band is, we're going to do the same thing. And then right where the scissors with this band in, we're going to go. I like to go towards the path because if something should go a lot, you know, cough, bark or something, it's a lot quicker to hair back in and then the section that's going forward. And we just continue all the way up. Okay. So now see how this hair kind of wants to be like an afghan, like it doesn't really want to stand up. Now is you really want to make sure that you like kind of preserve that, put some scissoring spray on it. I want to make him look like he has lots of angulation. I want to create this rear angulation. And I want to make sure that his pack remains, you know, slightly heart-shaped at all times. And nice and close to the body. So now
steers right on this line, and it's going to make a nice curved middle bracelet. I understand what my dog's ambulation needs to look like at the end of the day. When I do the back bracelet, I'm sorry, the bottom bracelet, I want to make sure that this is curved at about like a 30% angle as it comes off the top of the foot. And then again, I want to make sure that I make that band go all the way around the leg. So now we can see that we have like, basically we've set like the bones of this trim, like we have his tetherlons in, except for we don't have the kidney patch in. The kidney patch goes right here. The kidney patch was designed so when dogs were treading water, that like they didn't have a lot of hair here that would get in the way of their rear legs and they're making a turning motion, right? So it really doesn't have anything to do with like where the kidneys are, which is what people think. It's because people used to say it was kidney shaped. I don't know really what shape it is, but what I will say is the biggest mistake people make with the kidney patch is they make it too long, right? Because anything that we make long here makes our dog look longer back. We can make a big dog look smaller by making that kidney patch narrower. We can make a smaller dog look bigger by having the kidney patch wider, right? All of those things. And sometimes I'll put my clipper, and I'll just do this tuck-up. Like with my clipper, I'll just kind of run it along the top of this tuck-up just to clean up this area right in the pack. I don't do that on puppy trim. The only time it really works for me is on the saddle. So always remembering that this looks slightly heart-shaped as we come down. The top of the pack is slightly smaller than the neck, the bracelet, the middle bracelet, and the bottom bracelet. When I go to start setting in the kidney patch, the first thing I like to do is, you can see my clipper line right here, that's making the difference between my pack and my jacket. So the first thing I like to do is kind of pull all this hair forward of that line, and of the clipper line, and I'm going to put my shears right on it and take everything that goes forward over that line, that really sets the line in my pack, and then I'm going to do the reverse. And always when I'm trimming, doesn't matter continental or English saddle, when I'm trimming right here, this area of my trim, I'm always going to point the jacket slightly forward. Because when your dog is sprayed up, the hairspray automatically pushes this coat down over that line. You can see how it's already coming down over that. So I always like to take my stray shears and I'm just going to tip it slightly towards his head. The inside of the leg is 1/3 of the width of the entire leg. And I just run my scissors down the inside to begin with to kind of clear out the bulk of the coat. Now with the kidney patch, for him, you know, he's doesn't have a lot of neck that we discussed, so I want this to be kind of as little as possible. I don't really want to draw attention to like where his back is in relation to his neck. So I'm just going to go in with these curved shears, and I'm going to put it in about the middle of, like from this cup up to the top of this body, about in the middle, so I'm using my curved shears backwards. And I'm just going to kind of scissor it in. So a little kidney patch. And then, you do have to prefer that in. There's some judges that will get
I like to just sit them in and not cripple them, but there are judges that will kick them out if they're not crippled in. Because the standard does say it will be crippled. I'm just going to take off this big blue judy that they don't want. So making sure that we're creating angulation with this little bracelet is a very important part of this trim. Making the band too big at the top or too wide can really be problematic. So this band here, you don't want this band too wide or this band. So making sure that it looks balanced and even, you know, this takes you using your artistic interpretation of the standard, what you want this trim to look like, and just really putting it to work. And you can see, even when we look at them right now, how this piece of hair, like this top, is a distraction, right in here. So this is why we want to keep pulling this hair over that jacket line and making sure that we have it really kind of nice and neat up with the body. We want the body trim to look very round, especially on a toy. So any trim on a toy is going to be like slightly bigger and rounder than on a kind of standard, right? Because it can carry more hair. It doesn't move as much when you're moving. So really tapering the jacket up into the shoulder. And so when I am, now we can see how he likes to sit into his front, right? And so you have to really be careful that you don't let him do that, because that'll really change what your trim looks like. So you have to kind of like make him have good posture when you're doing this part. So here's what we talk about. You can see how he kind of looks like he has no neck. There's no front angulation there. So that's why we really want to put these shears on that 45 degree angle and really create that front angulation. So I'm going from here down into my underline to create that front angulation. And then from the front, I want to do the same thing. I probably use straight front standard, but here I'm going to... I'm also going to try not to pull off the seat. So I don't want to say it like this, because look at how much this trim changes, right? So from this line, I want to continue and make sure that we have that return of upper arm, that 45 degree angle. I want to pick up this leg. I want to make sure I make this underline be one line all the way under my dog. Thank you. bracelets, you want to make sure that you come off the foot at about that 30 degree angle. So when I come off the top of the foot, I'm not coming off the top of the toes, but again, I like to kind of pull this hair down. Put my tears on that clipper line and bring this out at about a 30 degree angle. And the same with this band here. Any of you have ever done an English saddle or heard it be called a curly pack, right? So a lot of times with these toys, but I like it on all three varieties, you want to make this the pack part look slightly curly, so have a different texture. And really, all you do is sometimes just like get it wet and let it get curly. It's important that you, just like any curly dog, that you let it, that you scissor the shape in there first. But we just like to get it nice and wet and let the curls form. I think it just adds like a little bit of dimension and makes the trim look a little bit tighter on their booties. And then once we kind of have the pack, right down, you kind of see maybe we'll taper it in a little bit more. So I always like to look down at my pack and look down at the back of the jacket, pull the neck, like really where you want it. And I don't ever want any hair, whether this is continental or in the center hanging over this line, right? This is when our dogs, it starts to, if you're spraying them up, this is where it starts to pull down. The spray up is right here. So if anything, I keep this really tight, and I'm going to like slightly taper it towards his head. So if you can set it up. Okay, so now that we have this part of this trim done, I wait for this to dry a bit, but I would just keep picking at his trim, now starting to finish it, put the finishing touches, make sure the bracelets look round, his body looks round, and has a finish on it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give him a break right now. I'm going to take your questions, and then I'm going to put a finish trim on him while you guys can wander around, you can shop, you can come up, ask me questions, take a look at him, anything you like. But I'll put a finish trim where about like 10 minutes till 11. That way I can take your questions, etc., and then work on it. So, does anybody have any questions? So it depends on the dog, and you can maybe show me more on your, on what we do the puppy trim, or I can even show you on the bitch. But I want this angle. It's hard to see on him because toys have a rounded trim, but I'm going to keep on this here. But if we have this on a 45 degree angle, right, we want it to be as, we don't want to hold our shears in like this way, we want to hold our shears out this way and create that line. And from there, I like to bring this line and just wrap it around, thinking of that 45 degree angle the entire time as I bring it into the other one, right? So you can also, it's the width of this line when you shave it is more important than what, how short this is. So many people have this line here, and they think that they need to do it because the neck looks too wide if they shave it here. But remember, the ring, their ears are always the problem, right? we give him a little break and work on it. If you guys want to come up and see him, ask any questions that we can try to ask in front of everybody, that's great. And then we start again at 1?
We have, Apollo puppy trim at 1.
Okay, yeah, so we start with the puppy trim. So if you have any questions or anything between then, I'm just going to work on him, then finish.
So we'll also do, we have two of the raffles we're going to do after, probably in like 15 or 20 minutes, let people ask their questions. We'll do the raffle, and then we'll do the other two raffles after the puppy trim. So that gives you guys time to go to lunch or come back or do whatever you got to do. And that's what we'll do. So yeah, if you could stick around, answer questions, and then we'll be back at 1 o'clock for Apollo as well.
Thank you very much.